Beware the tale of the snowman in 2021. Topic inspired by a YouTube comment. Just a comment, but great warning. So the comment went something like this. I built a snowman, and the neighbor called the police because why isn't there a snow woman? Made a snow woman. Had another neighbor call because the broom snow woman symbolized oppression and sexism and misogyny. And sexual harassment. So he put the broom away. Another neighbor called the cops. This guy is discriminated against the LGBTQ, EIEIO people. It's no tranny snowmen. No tranny snow people. So he builds one. And he goes into five or six more examples of this foolishness. But at the end of his comment, he says, no, there's no there's no tale or point or moral to the story. Just saying, these are the times that we live in, and they're only going to get worse. My Marine Corps days. I know a lot of gunnies, warrant officers, top brass, one star, two stars, that would be pissed off when they say that. When I was in, we used the terms nigger, faggot, kike, wetback, beater, gypsy, sand nigger. Well, everything. But you know what? When we use those terms, we made our communication genuine and clear. But we were weary of people that thought that was offensive. Because, you know, I've been to places, like I've been to the, they sell a Verizon phone. And years ago, I went to the store in Pasadena. Cancel my service. I think I was going with another phone provider for a better deal. And the dude's like, no, we need a social security card to cancel your phone. I'm like, fuck this guy, man. So he wasted my time, and I just called customer service and took care of it over the phone. And I just thought, you know, that's a dude that hated beaners. Wetbacks, didn't like wetbacks in this store. And that area was a white area. Mostly white. And I don't expect them to like me. You can imagine how many people, because people have to be politically correct, that don't know where people stand or to question their beliefs, their culture, where they come from. And Minecraft taught me mortality. You're black, who gives a fuck? You're from the hood, who cares? Pick that up, get it done. Oh, your mom owns this business. Your parents come from here. Oh, that's nice. All right, get your fire watch done. How is that relevant to the mission? I've talked with women who don't date Latinos, I mean Latinx, and some people got offended by her. She's racist. Why is she racist? She don't date Mexicans. I don't date homeless crackheads yet. Just not my thing. You're racist too. I looked at this sometimes it's hard going on a dog walk when you see these hot ass chicks in their yoga outfit or jogging outfits by themselves on the sidewalk wearing a fucking full on mask. What? Who's following you? Yeah, man. Again, if you disagree, dislike this video and leave a comment as to why I'm exaggerating, or better yet, make a YouTube video as to how the white snowman is keeping you down. I think that was another point that that dude had made in the comment that, yeah, someone said it was Nazi because they used white snow, and I thought, fuck. Where the fuck I heard someone say, yeah, no, that's offensive. And as soon as that motherfucker said that, I thought, yep, I'm not gonna work with this fool, talk with this fool, hang out with him, or joke with him. And I'm gonna tell everyone that I know, don't do business with them. Because you're merely a a big booty remark. Fucking, wow, you're looking amazing today. Coming away from a sexual harassment suit. Yeah, but that's how we're living now. Definitely would be having a not fun time. But I just got out the Marine Corps and had to deal with, I don't know, such complaints, I guess. Complaints? Yeah. Nagging. And it's commentary like that that does make me ponder. Is this all worth it? In some sort of depressing perspective. Because I think, fuck, dude, we're. Hope you don't infect Mars with this sort of, I won't even say caveman thinking. This sort of spineless jellyfish thinking. No offense to a spineless jellyfish. I forget what crime I saw recently, but I think two or three times I haven't called the cops because I said, hey, look, it's your stuff. Stand up for it. But, people don't want to now. again, it's a mixed bag of emotions, because, you know, for a majority of my life, majority of people that I communicated with, exposed to, worked with, hung out with, worked out along with, have this idea of, like, who cares? That's not my problem. I gotta worry about what I'm gonna make for dinner. I have to worry about getting cheaper auto insurance. I have to worry about paying my phone bill. And I think of actual hardship, man. And there's some things that I blocked out in my mind. Some tragic stories, because I have a friend of mine, love this bastard, because he's chosen to be a good person, even after going through some, to put it simply, hard times in life. Hard fucking times. My battery's at 15%. But yeah, no, this dude, man, good guy, man. And I think of him as an example. Like, hey, get it done, man. Get it done. Look at this dude, man. This dude still laughs, still works, still puts out, man. Still believes in himself. This friend of mine probably, like, lives an hour and change away, so my visits aren't as frequent. But I know that if I get a big fat ass paycheck, I know who I'm going to share the rewards with. That's it for now, motherfuckers. Get after it, go forward. Trump 2020. Resist the tyranny of 2021.